Welcome to the Auto Fire Power Hour. Very, very special for me. Let's play.
It's special specifically for you.
We are going to do Sonic 3 and Knuckles.
Well, you are going to do Sonic 3 and Knuckles. I'm merely here as a cheerleader, and I'll try to keep it as glass half full as I possibly can.
But, excellent. Thank you.
If I'm honest, I've been playing...
That should be extremely easy to do in what is one of the best video games ever made.
It is a really good game.
I will agree
that it's a really good game.
So just for everyone watching at home or wherever you are, I hope you're working and deciding to watch this.
Yeah, I hope you're taking a shit.
So I deleted every save game that was on here.
Uh-huh.
I started a new
because
game.
This is yours. You bought it.
Yes, that's right. So to be fair, as soon as I bought it, that was the first thing I did.
Yeah,
I got rid of everyone else's garbage.
It's like you marked your territory.
Yeah, and I sprayed all over this.
Yeah.
And then I started a new game. I played through Sonic 3. I got all the Chaos Emeralds.
Right.
And then what happens is when you go to Sonic and Knuckles, when you start playing Sonic and Knuckles, before you even kind of play the first level, you get taken to... Knuckles' secret lair.
Right.
Where he protects all the Chaos Emeralds.
Mm-hmm.
You get sucked there, or not, you watch Knuckles go into a secret hideout.
Mm-hmm.
And then he comes back out and he leaves. And then you're like, well, where did he go?
Right.
Right? Because you've been following him throughout Sonic 3.
And then Sonic gets his fingers out.
So Knuckles leaves, Sonic goes in there, mm-hmm. and all your Chaos Emeralds get sucked out and get put in, different podiums.
Right.
And then it dawns on you, oh, this is where Chaos Emeralds are from.
Mm-hmm. This place that Knuckles has been stashing.
Yes. So then, once all the Chaos Emeralds are out, you jump on one, and it takes you to a special stage, and if you beat it, you find out that you can now get Super Emeralds.
Okay. And that would be... Is that the big green one you have there?
That's the big green one.
Okay.
So, before you even play Mushroom Hill Zone, which is the first level of Sonic and Knuckles,
uh-huh.
you have the opportunity to get one.
Okay.
So I got that one, and then now we're going
to... Now the attempt is to get all of the Super Emeralds.
Yes.
And hopefully get to the Doomsday, which is something I've never seen in this game.
So the Doomsday level is the very last level that you can only get if you have all the Super Emeralds.
Right.
So one cool thing is when you play Sonic and Knuckles without Sonic 3,
uh-huh.
Tails isn't in it.
He's not in it?
He's not in it.
Oh, I didn't know that.
So this is the only way you can get... Oh, so here you go.
It's like they withheld that as a thing. Like, no, you gotta have the other game in order to get it.
Yeah, kinda. So there we saw him leave his secret... Oh, so it's gonna let me go again.
No,
it's not. Okay.
So was there a ring here?
Yeah, okay. There was a ring here. And that kind of shows you, the ring was taking you to this level all the
right.
whole time. So we're gonna do an episode on this game?
Yes.
And,
what's interesting, I think, about the episode that we're gonna do is, you're doing the episode with your frame of reference being, of pure love. You really, really adore this game.
Yeah, no, this game's awesome.
So I think that Sonic & Knuckles is a fine game. It's well made, it's fun. There are some criticisms that I could levy towards the entire Sonic series in terms of me thinking they haven't aged super well, but overall I think they're great games. But I'm more interested in Sonic and Knuckles from a business standpoint. I think it's, at the same time, it's this really innovative thing that's never been done before and it hasn't really been done since.
Okay.
Aside from modern DLC. But at the same time, it was kind of a sketchy thing. It's kind of a cash grab, I feel like.
Okay. Well, we can get into
that.
Oh,
we will get into that when we do the podcast. Certainly. I just want to get that out there as what my interests in Sonic and Knuckles are.
Yeah.
And why I allowed you to tie me up to this.
to force you to do
yes,
this.
Yes, yeah. I'm tied up in a rocking chair with wire.
So we kind of have limited time because we're not trying to make our Let's Play episodes turn into playthroughs.
Yes.
So I'm trying to speed through this, but bear with me because the first couple zones. Look at that.
It happens.
That's novice material right there. But the first couple episodes or the first couple zones, I'll be looking for places that I can get some of the super emeralds.
Mm-hmm.
So there'll be a little bit of exploration, at least in the first couple levels.
And so just like in Sonic 3, those are the big rings that you find, right? Like, hidden, sometimes very well hidden, sometimes kind of more out in the open.
Yeah, sometimes hidden, sometimes not quite so hidden.
And then there's other special stages in this game too, right? There's like there's that one that's almost like a there you go.
So do you see how that was flashing colors?
Uh-huh.
So this is the
podium thing that you're talking about.
So this is like Knuckles' secret layer.
Isn't it called Hidden Palace or something like that?
Hidden Palace is a later level.
Oh, okay.
That is kind of like the
entrance. That's where you fight Mecha Sonic is Hidden Palace, right?
You do fight him there, and then, but that's kind of the entrance into this layer.
Okay.
Right? So this is deep inside Hidden Palace.
Deep within its moistened walls.
So you jump on one, and then you go. And I'm super nervous, because I really want to get all of these.
No pressure, dude. You're going to go for it.
Okay, so I got 31 total to go. I vaguely remember this level, but we'll see.
I was just gonna ask what the gold ones do, but then I just saw it, so it's okay.
Woo! I'm dead.
Oh, nope! That was amazing. Survive.
Yeah, but not in quite the pickle. So I think after this I gotta jump.
There we go. Yep.
Woo! Glad I got out of that. But, didn't really feel like I was gonna escape that at the time that it happened.
There we go. Now we're back in the game. Oh!
You see that?
I did.
The skills.
I think watching you play this game is actually more entertaining to me than playing the game.
Because it's frustrating if you're not very good at like this part of it.
Yeah, and I just... to me, it's not exactly worth all the effort to try to get really good at it as an adult.
Five more. One, two, three, two more.
Boom!
Boom!
Got it. We are well on our way.
So do you see that? It even has the sprite for a super emerald.
Oh, there! I thought it was just an enlarged emerald. It's just it's a whole different sprite.
Yeah, and then watch what happens.
Whoa! This is new.
Isn't that cool?
That's cool. I've actually because I suck at this game, I've never seen any of this crap.
So like, there's all kinds of cool stuff that locking them on opens up.
Yeah.
So that, I think, was actually a bonus one. I think there's another place for me to get a super emerald in this level. Well, there's a few more places, but at least this first act, I think, is what I'm trying to say.
Right.
So, one of the things that I really like about just Sonic games in general is when they were making the first Sonic game, they were actually looking at Mario, and they made the decision. They said, you know, Mario's one of the beauties about Mario games is that they're simple. You have jump and you have a run button, which is also kind of a pickup button.
Well, there's some more dynamics that come into play when we get to Mario World, but for the most part, yeah, it's just run and jump.
Right. But I say that as a compliment.
Right.
So, and the reason why I say it as a compliment is the people who developed the first Sonic game, Yuji Naka,
the original Sonic game,
yeah, Hishimno or something, and this other dude. Anyways, doesn't matter. They looked at that and they said, how can we make a platformer that is actually even more simple in controls, only one button, but still just as involving from a gameplay perspective. And so they developed Sonic specifically to always only have one button.
Right, but then also, like, it's clear that the main factor behind Sonic games is the speed. Like, that had to have been...
That was also part of it. So, the main programmer Yuji Naka actually wrote the engine.
Yeah.
For the first Sonic game.
Yeah. He was actually quite the talented dude.
Yeah. And so I don't know what the prototype had in it, but he showed the prototype to another developer. The guy who actually created the character of Sonic.
Yeah. Well, it was... So the original character in
which is
Sonic
like Hishinmo
was...
or something. Yeah. Is his name.
The original character in Sonic was a rabbit. And then he kind of... Like, that design got poo-pooed, and Sonic itself kind of came from, like, a really... early like focus test kind of thing back before that something like that really caught on.
Well, so from what I was reading, it wasn't really necessarily a focus test as much as it was like sort of a challenge to developers and designers within.
Yeah, exactly. It was a design by committee type thing.
Yeah. And it was left to an armadillo and Hishinmo's design, which was Sonic.
See, to me, Sonic has always reminded me of Felix the Cat. Like the big giant eyes and the big black...
So Hishinmo actually has said in interviews, all I did was take the face of... Oh, I only got one. I love that. Bummer. All I did was I took the face of Felix the Cat and I put it on Mickey Mouse.
Right. So it's like,
and that's how I got Sonic.
Yeah. He's a super mascot.
And he's said to have in like one interview he said like he's like, I was actually surprised that no one at Sonic figured that out.
Right.
No one at Sega figured that out.
Well, you know, it's crazy. It's a testament to how powerful the design is, because like they've made some really, really just dreadfully bad Sonic games. And people, they still make them. People still recognize the character. He still sells toys.
Yeah, no, for sure. Well, I mean, you know, he's bright and blue.
Yeah.
So there's that.
Well, I just think that the 16-bit Sonic games, like, there's so much reverence for them that, like, Sonic almost kind of, like, still exists on their coattails to a pretty large extent. I mean, look at Sonic Mania. That Sonic Mania is, like, an answer to, like, the Sonic fans' wet dreams.
Yeah, totally.
Although there are people, I don't really get it, but there are people that love all those 3D Sonic games.
Let's see if we can get our third one. I don't know what this is.
Yeah, this is pretty nerve-wracking just to watch.
There's a part in here, actually, that I should try to get before I get the rest of it. Mm-hmm.
Ooh.
I might have screwed up right there.
Well, let's just hope for the best. It's the only way I'll get untied from this chair.
We'll get through it.
And then maybe I'll get a sandwich.
Only if we're good.
It's been 2 weeks, right? Oh, what? Why didn't they pop into rings?
They have to have spheres within it.
I see.
They don't.
Oof. I saw some. I thought I saw some blue orbs. Oh! Oh, good luck there. Oh, man.
I've actually done this.
Oh!
Shit! Oh, that really sets us back. That's okay. That level's hard.
I will get a sandwich.
That playing that level right now, because I haven't played Sonic & Knuckles in a long, long time.
Mm-hmm.
Playing that level right now instantly destroyed my confidence in being able to get all the Super Emeralds in this playthrough. But I'll stay positive. We'll see what we can do.
And I will endure.
Yeah, you'll make it.
I'm just a little Sonic fatigued, because in doing research play, as I tell my wife it is, I've been playing this game, and then Sonic 2 with Knuckles, and then we just played a bunch of Chaotix, so I'm like kind of feeling a Sonic fatigue, but I'm going to power through.
Okay. Well, that's unfortunate. I mean, so let's just, I mean, we're playing this kind of frantically, but I knew that was going to happen. So we're sort of playing this frantically just to kind of get through it, but this game is pretty damn You have to admit. And I feel like this really holds up. I mean, I think...
Oh, yeah.
The quality of all... I mean, this could be made today and I think come out.
I think the bit when we get into the podcast, we, you know, talk about like things aging. I think the thing that stands out the most as aging well is the look and sound of Sonic Kings. I think they're every bit as good today as they were back then.
See, this could have been our fourth one.
Right. How many is there total? Six or seven?
Seven. Okay.
So when you get all these super emeralds, you're gonna get access to Hypersonic.
Yep.
Isn't he just supersonic but with like more sparkles?
Supersonic with more sparkles.
Yes.
Yes.
I stand by what I said.
Yes.
They couldn't have.
That's not exactly how I would describe him because he is hypersonic, which makes him sound a lot cooler than.
Right, but in reality, it's just supersonic with extra sparkles.
Okay. They could have made him look. If that's the way you want to look at it, that's fine.
They could have. All I'm saying is they could have like, give him a different color, just a little bit more spice would have made that steak a little better. That's all I'm saying. Especially because you're doing this to get it. This is not easy.
It's not that hard either. I just kind of led.
Well, for a fucking a Sonic savant like you.
We're recording for like, you know, at least five people, and like, that's a lot of pressure.
Right.
So I just kind of collapsed under it, alright?
I hope these people don't suffer from epilepsy, because this level is looking pretty dangerous in that category. Oh, you're getting close.
Yeah.
I think you might get it.
Yeah.
There they are.
Boom.
Boom.
That makes me super disappointed that I lost it the last time. Because that really wasn't that hard.
Right.
There's a later level where the most obvious path isn't the one you want to start with.
Mm.
And I thought it was that one, and that wasn't it.
Well, it doesn't matter. You got...
Well, what's cool is we get this.
We have only three more to go, right?
We get this awesome sort of cutscene. Sonic was way better when it had minimal cutscenes. Like this, where it's just like, okay, I get the whole story just by watching that. I'm done. I can move on. I don't need a talking Sonic talking with like some 16-year-old.
Well, I'll do you one even better. I only give a shit about Sonic, a little bit of fondness for Tails, and Jaleel White and Chili Dogs, and that's as far as I go with Sonic's deep and rich canon. Like, I don't give a shit about it, and. It actually amazes me that so many people are like so into it. Like it's really crazy to me. And even as a kid, I never gave a
shit.
So
this is something I want to talk. I'm going to talk about the episode, but I feel like it's this combination of Sonic 3 and Sonic and Knuckles that solidifies Sonic in the culture.
Mm-hmm.
That for everything you're talking about that you don't get, all comes from this game. I feel like so. We would have had just two more to do after the very first level.
Yeah.
But I fucked it up. So let's see if I can do this one.
Yeah, see, but to what you were saying right now, like, that, it's what complicated Sonic, and that's kind of one of the things that has turned me off on the series, aside from them making bad games.
Okay. Fair enough. This one's difficult.
Yeah, this one looks stupid hard.
So if you want to get all the coins, you gotta do this.
There's no benefit other than you unlocking continues, right?
Yeah, I already have like seven continues, which is like seven more than I need.
Right. Oh! You got Mally. You got Mally and you bought it.
Darn it! So now we don't get any cutscene. That really sucks. That's okay. We'll have more opportunity later.
So did you get Sonic & Knuckles when it originally came out?
Yes.
Okay.
So Sonic & Knuckles was my first Sonic game that I got the moment it came out.
Okay. And the other ones you, like, just procured along the way?
Yeah.
I got Sonic 1 when it was a pack-in with the Genesis. So I think that may have been... Well, I got it Christmas of 1992 is when I got my first Genesis.
So have you seen the special stages in this?
Yeah. There's the one that looks like a capsule machine. Then there's this one, which is weird. And then there's the a very standard Sonic slot machine deal. So I don't like this one, but I will say that it's really nice when you have all the Chaos Emeralds, because it's super easy to get a lot of keys in it.
I think the background is Maximum Trip.
Yep. This is, I just gotta say, this is, in my opinion, the best looking Genesis game.
I think it looks really
good.
It's
beautiful. I think it's well polished. I think everything looks fantastic.
I kind of think that you have Sonic blinders on.
Are you telling me this doesn't look good?
No, of course I'm not saying that. I've said all along, like, everything about... So Sonic, they're well-made games. They look good. They sound great. But none of them are, like, what I would consider, like, the best Genesis games on any front. On audios, visuals, or being super fun.
I don't see how you can look at this and not think this is like...
Well,
I think this is one of the best 16-bit games ever made.
Yeah, I know you do. I know you do, man. But I would...
And I don't see how anyone could really argue.
I would put Gunstar Heroes over this. I would put...
I would put
Alien Soldier over this.
I also would not do that.
Well, you know, you're a crazy person, and that's fine.
I think those are both great-looking games, but this is just like... It's so well done.
Have you played Ristar much? Or Ristar, however you pronounce it?
Yeah.
I think that's a really, really good-looking Genesis game. It's very colorful.
Okay.
This game, well, okay, this level in particular, like, it's actually one of the, in my opinion, it's one of the lesser levels visually.
Mushroom Hill Zone?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, the background is so flat. Like, look at that. It's just been blue the whole time. There's hardly any parallax scroll
in the
background.
Are you kidding me?
It's a fact, dude.
Oh my! I wish we could play that over.
I don't.
The background color changed 3 different times.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I get it. Like the season
there's parallel,
stuff.
There's parallel, parallax scrolling. Like there's at least 8 different levels of it.
Now there's
yes.
There was
there,
totally there
was
a whole
is.
There was a whole lot of flat tree background that didn't
no.
that didn't scroll much. Well, you know what? As they say, we'll look at the tape. We'll look
we,
at the tape.
We'll look
the
at
fact.
The tape.
I like it. We barely started and we've already started arguing. But you know what? That's what I signed on for. That's what I wanted to do.
I bet you died a lot of times in this level.
Oh, you know I did.
So this level, I'm not actually. I've never been able to find any of the rings on this level.
The
so
big
I'm,
rings.
So
rather.
I'm just gonna fly through it.
Yeah.
And you're gonna see how freaking awesome Sonic games are. Look at this. See, the thing is, so I call those things. You were talking to me before we started recording this that there's these quote-unquote autoplays.
Yeah.
And I think what you mean by that is the segments where you have to press forward or to some direction.
You basically hold down one button and then the Sonic games just play themselves.
For a second.
For chunks at a time.
So I call those runs because I'm freaking cool and that's how I do things.
And this is like, this is a... creep furry Sonic lingo that I should be.
No, I mean I'm not aware of anybody calling it that. That's just what I refer to him as I play through these.
Well, it is clearly Sonic and one of his pals running past, so it makes a lot of sense.
But I love those things, and I think particularly Sonic 3 and Knuckles do those very, very well.
Yeah.
In Sonic 3 and Knuckles, they're often broken to segments. So depending on, like, some platforming portion before it, if you got to the highest level or the hardest part to get on that platforming section, you get a longer run.
Yeah.
And if you went through some of the easier parts, that run is shorter, right? You get the tail end segment of it.
Okay,
so there are actually rewards to platforming.
All right.
In a lot of the levels.
See, to me, the autoplay stuff is one of the, if not the main reason why I have kind of tapped out on Sonic games. And when I was going back to play this to talk about it, I realized that this is kind of, they've kind of always been in Sonic games, but in Sonic and Knuckles, there is just a lot more of it. And I think at the time it was really cool because it was like this, like you know, it's like this really.
This segment.
Yeah, it was like this visual showpiece that shows off how fast.
But then if you just go through, like, have you ever noticed these?
Sometimes you do, and sometimes you just whiz right by them.
That's the point. Like, they're there
They're there so that you can use them if you're just playing through.
Well, then, what you just did right now is actually kind of more of a... It's actually a bad example to what I'm actually talking about. I'm just talking about the parts where, like, Sonic... Where you don't have any control, and Sonic's just kind of zipping on by, and all it is...
If you let him.
No. Like, when he's in tubes and like, very forced pathways where you can't... You have zero control. And it's a thing that the Sonic games, like, now do way too much... And it kind of started being too much in this game. I just like, I want to be able to control my dude at all times. That's one of the reasons why I prefer Mario games to Sonic games, because there's not any point in a Mario level where you're not always controlling Mario.
Move back.
Oh! Oh!
Oh, cool. So I hear what you're saying, and Sonic games are set up that you can just speed through them like that, but then you miss a lot of what the game has to offer, is what I'm saying. And they're set up that way so that somebody can come through and say, oh, this is cool, I'm just gonna run through this level and have fun. But to beat the game, you've gotta kind of find out this other stuff.
Yeah, but a lot of the exploration in Sonic games is like, it's like totally arbitrary. It's just like you get, you know, rings so that, yeah, I mean, you're jacking up your score. Or in the later Sonic games, you get, you know, the various power-ups and stuff like that, which is obviously more beneficial to you. But it's like, yeah, obviously Sonic is known for its playability because it just feels fun to run through levels. And for those inclined, they can take their time and really explore everything. I just don't think that the reward of exploration in Sonic games is as good as the rewards that you get from exploring in like a Mario World or Mario 64. I mean, okay. You get like entire like levels or like they're like secret exits. I mean, we'll get into it. I'm gonna get into it when we have our big blowout, our verbal battle over the better game.
Yeah, I don't know. In my opinion, like. It's all just like extra. There, you get in, Sonic games are about rewarding you within each act, right? Which is something totally different than, say, Mario World. You get rewarded within the act for a platforming. So like if you do a hard platforming section, you will get rewarded with like a longer run,
yeah,
or like something fun to do.
It's or not, something fun to sit through and
you're
watch.
Not unlocking something, it's something fun to go and do.
It
gives you the sense of accomplishment because I understand what you're saying, it's just one button input.
Yeah.
This goes back to me talking about earlier, like their point was to make it as simple as possible.
Yeah.
But it's only one button input, but you have the sense that you actually are responsible for it happening.
See, hold on. Look at the parallax scroll in this background. When you move left and right, like the layers of the top now work out there.
There's tons.
This level has way more of that shit than Mushroom Hill.
I will review the tape.
Look, man, I think Sonic games are fun. Like I don't think they're shitty games by any means, especially the 16-bit ones. I just think that the elements that you're talking about of like the reward, I don't think that's aged as well as maybe you think it has.
All right, whatever you say. See, I'm sure there's some special rings in here somewhere, but I've
got
no idea where they are.
This level, this world called again?
Fortress.
Flying battery or flying?
Yeah.
Flying battery.
Yeah.
These levels are pretty damn big.
Oh yeah, totally.
Ooh, that's smooth.
This is one. So like this run is about 40% longer than if I went the other way.
Right. And that's just by virtue of, like, coming into the path, right?
Yep. No, virtue of me going and finding it. Like, by taking a harder route.
Right. That's what I mean.
But this level, to be honest, is probably the worst of the Sonic and Knuckles levels to argue my point. Because it does have a lot of areas where you do a run and there's no extra stuff you're missing,
yeah,
or anything like that. I mean, there's a few portions.
See, right there is one of those cheap deaths that I think there's too much of. No, you didn't, because you know what you're doing. But if you're just playing this for the first time, like I bet almost everyone dies there. It's like a completely blind fall on spikes.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I didn't die there.
Again, you've probably played more Sonic and Knuckles than
than
10 men.
I would love to find a chaos.
Well, that is what we need in order to get hyper.
I'll be really disappointed if I don't get it.
Well, you know, oops. I may get untied. This isn't even a boss.
Look how cool the robot looks.
He does look really cool.
Dude, he looks pretty dang cool.
He's always looked really cool. He's an egg with tiny little legs and a giant mustache. Have you ever played Bonanza Brothers? Yes. That's one of my cult favorites. My personal cult favorites. But there's a character, like an enemy, that looks a lot like Robotnik.
So, I'm going to point out one of the reasons why I think Sonic 3 & Knuckles is so great.
Well, it better not be this boss, because this boss is...
Well, this is just a prelude. So we find Robotnik at the center of the flying battery, and
this part of the little...
I don't know why he has a laser that's... anyways, he has a laser. He decides to point it at us, and ends up, because we're so fast and devious, he ends up... missing us and destroying his whole ship. And now his ship is crashing.
What a dick.
Right? Like, I just think this is cool. Like, it's creating a narrative. See, I never... in a very minimal way.
I see what you're saying as you describe it to me, but I never really gleaned that. I don't know if that's me being dense or not.
Okay, super obvious.
Was it super obvious that that's what was happening?
That was exactly what's happening. Because in the first level, the fortress flies by you, and then you jump into it, right? So, like, you know, it's easy to kind of start seeing what's going on. Tails. Totally fine. Tails.
Ray, have you ever bought a Sonic comic book?
No, I haven't.
Okay.
That was embarrassing. That was a big issue. No, I haven't. I've read a few of them. For instance, like, I've read the first one, which is kind of like the origin of how Sonic became Sonic.
He has an origin story?
Yeah. You don't know the origin story? It's actually the origin story for both Sonic and Robotnik.
Okay.
So Robotnik was a good scientist at some point. And he had this experiment to, you know what? I don't know what the experiment was. It was some experiment that involved running on a treadmill. So Sonic came in, and he was actually a brown hedgehog with like a lot of little tiny spikes. He ran on the treadmill, and something went tragically wrong and shocked both of them. Sonic became like hyper fast and blue,
and then Robotnik just became an asshole.
Yes, red and an asshole. So, there you go. That's how it happened. Locked in eternal struggle ever since.
The yin and yang. How did you? Because I've never heard that before.
That's in an Archie comic.
It is an Archie comic. Okay. Those Archie comics are still being made.
That's retarded. I don't understand that at all.
Well, dude. People still fucking adore Sonic the Hedgehog. I mean, look what we're doing in your garage. And we're in our mid-30s, for fuck's sake.
Yeah, but I mean, like, I don't subscribe to all that stuff. Like, I know about the story, but I know it specifically from what, you know, maybe somebody who reads Archie comics would call canon, which is Sonic 1, 2, and 3 and Knuckles, right? Like, I know it from playing this game and reading the manual as a kid, and that's it, right? So anyway, so the fortress has been destroyed, and I'm jumping ship, right?
Yeah.
And I land in the desert.
I'd be also willing to wager, Ray, that you may have bought a Sonic young adult novel or two from the bookmobile in your day, and maybe you just forget.
No, I just know what I know from the games. That's it. So I like this level. I think I think the design of this level is really cool.
I think visually this is probably my favorite level in the whole game. I love how it looks. I'd even dare say it might be the best looking Egyptian / desert themed level in a 16-bit platformer.
And it does really cool stuff like this.
Look at the skyline. It's awesome.
Yeah, it's really cool looking.
Mm-hmm.
I just feel like the pace is a little bit too slow for my liking.
Yeah, there's a ton of break up. The speed is diminished heavily in this level.
Yeah. So I'm kind of searching for some more opportunities to get this.
So I kind of forgot when you lock on Sonic 3 and Sonic and Knuckles that you play. It's like you play Sonic 3 and then you play Knuckles.
Yep.
I always thought. Well, I should say, you know, because it had been years since I played these games. I always thought it was like kind of like a mix. Like an alternating kind of deal.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
No, it's you play one.
Yeah, it's one and the other.
It's a large story, is what it is.
Yeah, a story where like the second half of the story is so much better than the first half.
You're talking about the Sonic and Knuckles is better than Sonic 3?
Yeah.
But that's literally impossible because they're literally the same game.
No, I think that's the as two separate products, two cartridges that you could buy back in the day.
Okay.
The levels that are contained in Sonic and Knuckles are more interesting. They're more fun. They look better than everything that's on offer in Sonic 3, with the exception of Angel Island. I think Angel Island looks tremendous.
Oh, Angel Island is fantastic.
Yeah.
Wow, that's really interesting to me.
And I also feel like since like the development, which we'll get into in the podcast, but like it really feels like they had a little bit more time with the second half of the total package being not Lex Luger, but
well,
Sonic
that was
and
Knuckles. That was one of the reasons they decided to do it in two releases.
Yeah.
I really want to find a reason here to jump into.
Well, it would benefit the cause, that's for sure.
Okay.
Man, Knuckles sure would be handy here.
He sure... Knuckles, for sure.
You prefer to play as Sonic?
Yeah, I don't know. It's all the same.
Well, it's not all... I mean, Knuckles fucking flies and climbs. It's awesome. And so helpful.
Yeah, I think it's easier to
play. It makes the game so much easier.
I think it's easier to play as Knuckles. I don't think you can fully beat the game. I don't think you can get to the Doomsday level as Knuckles.
Really?
Yeah.
But there's a Hyper Knuckles level.
I don't think it matters.
Huh.
I could be wrong.
Yeah, I would actually be really surprised if features of the game were hidden behind a Sonic wall.
One of the reasons why this game is so cool is there's just... Each level adds something kind of new and interesting in terms of... Just something that you kind of didn't expect, like this kind of the spring-loaded stuff.
Oh, those things?
Yeah, these things.
Yeah.
Just kind of like, what? What's that?
It's just a variation of that.
I know that this level has like three or four of them, and the fact that I haven't found one yet is kind of frustrating.
They all have a ton of them, though, right? These levels are fucking gigantic.
Yeah, they're really big. And, like, this is cool, like, just these little extra sort of animations.
yeah, there's definitely a lot of polish on this game. To a large ring, and then a super emerald.
I sure hope so.
Somewhere up there.
Yeah. I guess through one of the walls.
There are a lot of sneaky walls in this game.
Yeah, somebody who knows how to play this game is watching me and going like, oh my god, dude!
You're terrible!
He's some,
But to be fair, I haven't played this game in probably about 15 years, and I just
really
don't remember everything.
The last time I had played any of these games, with the exception of Sonic 2, was when the Sonic's Genesis Collection came out for PS3 a couple years back. What the fuck now, like 8 years back. But that had all the Sonic games on there, and I played them a fair amount. And then recently, playing through a majority of it.
Yeah, I would say maybe between 20 and 22 is the last time I played these.
Sonic 1 and Sonic 2, I have pretty much like almost totally committed to memory. Like, I just remember everything about those games. But by the time Sonic 3 came out when I was a kid, I had lost a little interest in Sonic. I was way more into fighting games and stuff.
Okay.
I still loved, you know, my Marios. I got Mario All-Stars and all that crap. Which I think was the same. I think Mario All-Stars was the same year as Sonic 3.
So, I remember the first time I ever played this guy, which this guy looks fantastic, by the way. I'm just gonna throw that out there. I had no idea what to do. It took me forever to beat this guy.
Really fantastic. I mean, I
say that. I say that with like a
was a tongue firmly in cheek.
Yes.
Okay. Good.
Oh, Jesus. Maybe that gives me an opportunity to find a ring here. Just got it.
Oh yeah, we're back a little bit. I do appreciate that those finding the big rings in this game. Like, all you have to do is find them. Like, you don't have to have a certain amount of rings, like in the special stages for Sonic 2.
Yeah, I especially like that every platforming section that you need to, that you can explore and find that gets you to one, you don't have to backtrack ever.
Right.
I think that's the failure of, if there is one, to Knuckles Chaotix, is you have to backtrack after the, after you find the dead, like the reward. In this game, when you find the reward, you can easily just continue with the level by continuing the same path you were,
you know, that you were on.
Which I think is a part of the genius of the game design.
Yeah, and a lot of the rings too are on these like little alcoves that are just like just slightly off the path.
Yep. And Sonic 3 and Knuckles especially, most of the levels branch off, except for some of, it's like the second half of this zone, there's pretty much one path to go.
Mm-hmm.
But the challenge is something completely different. It's about timing, in terms of achieving a goal within a certain time limit.
Right.
But a lot of levels like this one branch off into at least three different paths that you can take.
I don't think any Sonic game has more of that branching path feel, though, and like none of them executed as well as Sonic CD for me.
Okay.
I think the multiple paths in that game are very much defined, and the whole future path system just adds to the multiple path stuff.
Yeah, so, you know what's interesting about Sonic and CD? Is Sonic CD and Sonic 2 were developed at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
And the guy who actually created Sonic, is a Shin character. He stayed in Japan to develop Sonic CD. Yuji Naka came to Sega of America.
And yeah, and worked with Americans on 2.
On 2. So Sonic 2 is Yuji Naka's game, and Ishimu is the creator, the real creator of Sonic.
And we will get his name right at some point. Neither one of us wants to look it up.
Well, it'd be a lot easier for me if, like, I speak any word of Japanese.
Maybe. Right.
Well, I have to express my ignorance when it comes to Japanese.
It doesn't. People know. People know the general figure of who you're talking about.
So, one of the things that I think really shines about Sonic 3 and Sonic & Knuckles is you have a lot of different elements of kind of, you know, tried and sort of proven elements of 2D platformers that are incorporated into the game. So, like, this level is much... So there's 2D platformers where you have to achieve some sort of accomplishment
right
within the platforming within a certain amount of time, and there's a lot of games like that. And so this game is kind of doing that on this level, but then other levels are kind of totally different, right? Like some are more in the vein of Sonic 1, or
yeah,
you know, like, or and some are just like pure platforming.
This level reminds me of the Labyrinth Zone in Sonic 1.
Yeah.
With the crisscrossing bridges and stuff. I actually, when I was playing this game, I got stuck on this level, and stuck to a point where I was having zero fun, so I went ahead and skipped it. There's a few parts in Sonic & Knuckles that are like these loops, and, you know, It takes some figuring, which is an admirable thing. Like, it's cool that, like, there's, like, an element almost of, it's like rudimentary puzzle solving to get out of these places. But, I just found them frustrating and annoying.
It's because you don't have any patience.
That may or may not be true. I think I have patience with things I like a little more. I'll say that.
So this one was just, it's just a matter of finding, like, the, one of those sort of platform swingy things. I don't know what to call them.
Pendulum?
Pendulums. Oh my god, I get this.
Okay, you can't tail spin dash up there. Take it, Tails is pushing the opposite way. What a fucking asshole.
Yeah, I think it'll start over. I think it'll respawn the little block.
Tails is like the dude that, like, you know, he was, like, hanging out with you because he's someone's shitty cousin, and then, like, you know, it's ninth grade and someone has a joint.
Speaking of shitty cousins with a joint, you could join in as Tails at any point, by the way.
Oh my god, I could. But you'd have to untie my arms to allow that to happen. But yeah, anyway, Tails would be that shithead 13-year-old cousin that would act all cool, but then immediately run home and rat on his parents and get you in trouble.
I totally would. So I have a feeling down here is some sort of secret. I really hope it's a Chaos Ring. I'm kind of getting the feeling it's not.
Yeah, we've gone a pretty good amount without encountering one of those bad boys.
You guys are gonna start to come after me. Did this just start over?
Anything goes with this level. There's a lot of really annoying loops and shit.
Let's go ahead and get this
back. Yeah, they're really annoying.
This level, though, looks great too.
Yep.
I mean, really does.
I totally agree. The only level in Sonic & Knuckles that I actually take issue with saying it like it's such this wonderful, amazing-looking game, it is Mushroom Hill Zone. I think the foreground stuff in Mushroom Hill Zone is all crazy. Cool, but the background stuff is dumb and garbage.
You gotta admit, I can weave myself through this game pretty well. Yeah, I just can't freaking seem to find one of these.
See, I know when you're really mad when you start doing double frickins. double frickins means we're in a lot of hot water.
Yeah, that means like I'm so frustrated my Catholicism is coming out.
Yeah, dag nabbit! This darn thing,
this darn friggin' game. Meanwhile, I just got another one up by getting 100 rings.
If you were Mormon, you'd say flippin'.
Game.
This flippin' game! You'll get crushed.
Get crushed. Oh.
There's a thing up there on the left there.
Trying to getting a little desperate about finding one of these points.
Well, you're gonna run out of levels to get the opportunities pretty soon. Because after this is Lava Reef, right?
Yeah.
And that one's four acts, but I think one act, at least one act, is a boss fight.
Well, so Lava Reef has a lot of opportunities.
Oh, it does?
Yeah. I think you're missing one.
Is there any on Death Egg?
Ooh. Yikes. Yeah, I kind of tried to sacrifice myself because I thought I had one over there.
It's worth it. You have like 9 lives.
Not tonight! Yeah, missing, or not being successful on a couple of those really kind of hampered our chances. Because if I would have gotten both of them, we'd only need 2 more.
Right.
In terms of just sprites and backgrounds, I mean, every level has tons of just unique stuff that's not in it. Like the sand coming up and sort of,
yeah.
Like this is the only thing, it's specific to this level.
Well, it's just like in Flying Battery when, you know, it's a similar effect, but when the ship is being blown apart, which I apparently just learned is Robotnik's own doing.
Yes. Which was obvious, but go ahead.
Totally.
Just saying.
Well, what I take solace in knowing that there are support groups for people like you in the world.
I don't need a support group.
It's called Deviant. Just search Sonic on DeviantArt.
This game's great.
It is. I'm not denying that it's great.
And you said it yourself, like, it can be pretty darn hard, you know, like, did I just kill myself?
Yeah,
sure
you
did.
Yeah, it can be, there's challenge in this game that, like, it's a good feeling challenge where, like, you die and you know it's your fault. And then there are, like earlier that spike thing, like, there's just, like, the blanket deaths that just happen, and the only way to avoid them is to, you know, play the levels a few times. Which, I get it, you know, these things were expensive cartridges, and, like, there should be an element of a challenge to you know, keep you going, but just not a big fan of the cheap death stuff.
I honestly, and you can call me crazy if you want, I honestly believe that Sonic 3 and Knuckles has almost zero cheap deaths.
Yeah, I'll call you crazy.
I just don't think that there are.
With respect, though.
I think that you sort of learned. Like, I mean, so granted, I have played this game a lot in my life.
Yeah.
But I have not played this game in like 15 years. And I'm really just going off of my instinct of just playing a Sonic game.
Yes.
And, like, I feel like once I learn kind of how this game works and kind of how it wants me to play as Sonic, I feel like I can avoid pretty much any of those deaths because I kind of have the feeling that something like that is coming at certain points.
Well, yeah.
I don't know if that makes sense.
Nah, I just think you're just a bit of a Sonic apologist, which is fine. You can say the same thing about me and Mario games. I just think that, you know, I may have a little bit more support on my side. Maybe. I don't know.
Yeah. For sure. I'm in the minority. I'm not doubting that at all. I just have an argument that I feel like I can make, and I feel like it's relatively compelling.
Well, someone's got to do it.
Got the light. There it is. I'm not going to get it. Or any chaos.
Whoop.
You got it.
Oh, okay. That's automatic.
Did you see that little...
I did.
That flash move right there?
That was, that was split-second timing. Like I said, watching you play Sonic, to me, is more entertaining than me playing Sonic if I'm by myself.
Freaking just find one. I'd be content just with, like, finding one of these things. Wasn't quick enough on the draw.
You've gotten this far before, right?
What do you mean?
Oh, never mind. I thought this was a part of the stage that I'd seen before, but it's different.
No.
Okay.
Get one.
That sure does look like there should be one there.
Yeah, I must say, that must be the end of a different secret that I missed.
Oh.
Because these levels are pretty expansive.
That gate thing on the right there.
You get through it if you're not this.
You get punched through it?
Yeah. This part's good.
Reminds me of Battletoads.
It's just a little bonus for, like, getting this far. It's like, oh, you got this far, we'll give you this, and you get some points.
You're not beating up birds, though. Like in Battletoads.
That's true. You're never gonna hear me complain about Battletoads or... give any sort of fault to Battletoads.
I gotta get the Super Gun in here again, and we should play through the Battletoads arcade game that I have. That game is awesome. It's so violent. You can grab these enemies by the balls and annihilate their nuts. It's really satisfying.
I feel like I've played that.
You probably played it at, like, a Pizza Hut back in the day.
Okay.
It wasn't, like, a crazy popular game, but it wasn't super rare either. Why?
I ran out of time.
Oh, okay. I thought it was 15 minutes. They're 10 minutes.
Yeah,
10 minutes.
Fuck.
All right.
Exploring a little too much. That's okay. I hit a marker pretty darn close to where I just died.
Oh, thank God you murdered Tails. He's not gonna narc anymore. Oh, he's back.
I bet you I missed one up there.
Oh, you should have gone right instead of going down. Oh well.
It is what it is. Let's go.
Boss fight, it looks like.
Also, super cool boss fight.
I have always appreciated Robotnik's many forms.
They're all kind of fun.
Yeah, Sonic has always had really good boss fights for the most part. Some are better than others, but I can't think of one that's just, you know, awful.
Okay. thought that I'm not gonna like it.
Do you like Sonic 3D Blast?
No.
That's good. So you're not a full crazy.
No, dude, I'm really not like I said, I know a lot about Sonic literally because of Sonic 1, 2, 3, and Knuckles. Right? Like, that's kind of where my fanaticism is, and outside of that, you know, I don't really...
I grew up playing these games, too, and back then I certainly loved Sonic and had a deeper appreciation than I do nowadays. But I honestly didn't learn half of the fucking shit you did if you only allegedly learned them from the games.
I did. I totally did. And the manuals.
There's a bookmobile story in there somewhere.
This level looks awesome.
I think you bled your mom dry on a Scholastic sign-in sheet.
Tell me you at least think this level looks awesome.
I'm seeing through this. So.
It looks like a Sonic level. You don't think that the graphics in this level are awesome? I mean, look at that.
Now it looks awesome. Now it looks really
super
awesome.
Cool. Okay, now I'm kind of getting desperate to find it.
I bet you knew that I didn't give a shit.
Well, if you're gonna come into this like with that attitude,
with my stinky attitude,
yeah.
Well, you know, you told me that we were gonna play Street Fighter 2, and then you clubbed me in my head and tied me to a chair.
I never said that.
Yeah, you said it. You said, "Hey, dude, come on down. We're gonna play Street Fighter 2. I just got an arcade machine." And then I got my Datsun and I sped down here like a puppy, and then clubbed in the back of my head. You took chicken wire to me, and I'm tied to this rocking chair.
Look at this, that is cool.
That is neat. You can see the back of Sonic, which is cool.
I know that this level has a bunch of special secret areas.
There's a lot of spin dash gadgets in Sonic games.
Yeah.
Once they figured out the spin dash in Sonic 2, I feel like they were just like, well, we gotta use it. We gotta make little machines that use it.
Remember, they're achieving all these different things with one button.
Yes.
You know, like.
Well, they're achieving a spin dash.
Yeah, but you can say what you want. They're different mechanics.
Right. Well, no, the spin dash, the innovation of, or I should say the addition of the spin dash in Sonic 2, like, made Sonic games more fun, I think. And, like, the little gadgets that use the spin dash, those are just, like, little touches that I do appreciate. Are you dying on purpose?
Yeah, I think I missed it. I don't want to take a risk at this point. Feeling the massive pressure.
Right.
This guy's gonna screw up everything, but if you're smooth, you can jump across. Oh, it's just a one-up. That sucks. See how smooth I am with that? Okay, here's one for sure.
Alright.
For sure.
there
it is. There's another one, too. Okay, super, super nervous that we don't get this.
Well, we are approaching the hour 5-minute mark.
Okay.
If anyone is still with us, I'd like to personally offer my great appreciation, and I will now speak to you in code, and hopefully you understand the message that I'm relaying. It involves my freedom. Call the police. And that's my code.
That's not fair, man. Okay. This is gonna get a little bit tricky, I think. I think you're hinting at me to cut this let's play early.
No, I am not, and I'll tell you why.
All the best parts are coming up. Oh my god, I missed one.
I am not, Ray. We nailed it.
Did you see that? Did you see that?
I
jumped over like a bunch of red ones.
What do you want from me?
And I landed right where I needed to be. That was beautiful.
I would never cut this short, Ray. I would not do that to you. What I will do is sit through this until a point where you're comfortable, so that I know the cherry on the end on the top of the sundae is that I won't have to do it again.
Yeah. That's probably a good decision on your part.
Yeah, because I know it'll happen.
So I think there's another one.
Boom.
Okay. Extra.
Okay. So you have two more to go?
Three.
Two. Oh, God damn it! It's cool that you get to pick, though.
Yeah. Look at this level.
155? Fuck.
Yeah, this level's pretty good.
Do you like these special stages more than Sonic 2s or Sonic CDs?
I enjoyed them in Sonic 3 and Sonic and Knuckles. They get to a point where they're so hard like that.
Yeah.
This level's super challenging. And I haven't even sped up yet. You know?
Right. You still have so much more room for failure coming.
Yeah.
I really appreciate these, like, visually, and I do think that they're fun, if a little hard to control, but I like the Chaos Emerald stages and Sonic CD the most.
Yeah, me too.
Ah! Nailed it.
Woo! That level's hard. Did you see that? I didn't even flinch when I had to bounce backwards into the blue ones.
Yeah, that might have to
see that.
That might have
that
to do.
That is fucking skill,
it
brother.
It might have to do with the shot of Deca that you loaded up before we started this let's play here.
I feel a little bit more comfortable that now we only have two more.
Mm-hmm. Well, you still have a lot of stages left too to get them.
Yeah, but some of the later stages have a minimal amount of brains to jump into.
Does the game save with the moment you get an emerald, or do you have to beat a stage to get the save?
I do not remember it that well enough to tell you.
Those rocks that jettison out to the left and the right, they look like little baby dicks.
These ones?
No, the ones down there. It doesn't matter. Nothing matters anymore. Yeah.
Lightning! Thunder!
There, so right there, baby dick. What? Like a fallen. I think you're good.
Hey, okay. Gonna try to
just whiz by.
Oh,
there you go.
Whoops.
Whoops, a daisy.
That would never happen if I was trying. Just
no,
you know,
of course not.
Just in case anyone's judging at home.
Well, I hope you're not getting embarrassed in front of the multitudes of babes that listen to our show.
Anybody who is any good at Sonic games would watch me playing this right now and understand instantly that I'm pretty darn good.
Right, just so you know.
Plenty. I don't know if you're able to tell that, but I'm manipulating this thing pretty well.
You're definitely piloting this ship.
Oh, you see? Right after I'm talking to you.
Yep.
Just got a little too close to the sun there.
Did you see that timing of the fire thrust?
Ray, I see it every time. Every time. You've taped my eyelids open.
Just beautiful stuff.
You know, an eyedropper too wouldn't hurt. Just saying. This is the last time I let you take me captive.
I don't know why you're complaining about this.
It's fun. Mainly for the fun of it. I have to entertain myself somehow here. Really.
Yeah, no, I understand that. You should entertain yourself by talking about how gorgeous this game is.
This level looks good. There are rocks. Some of the rocks look like little baby dicks.
I don't see any of the...
You don't see the...
I can tell you're getting bored because get bored, you instantly start talking.
I start seeing... Right, and I start seeing penises and things that aren't there. Those are the ones. See, take a stop.
Oh, okay.
You see it?
Yeah, I can kind of see that.
Okay, good. Thank you. That's the only acknowledgement I've ever needed.
I can see it. I feel like it's a little bit of a stretch, but
yeah.
I do see.
Well, you're just, you know, you're so drunk on your catnip, which is Sonic the Hedgehog. Are you? We've been here before.
This is where I started when we died. I came down here. Did you? Oh, I know. Do that. Oh,
God. Why would a platform with rockets and then spikes require all that what appears to be LED readouts to make sure that it's properly plunging spikes into the ground?
Was it, why does it have something on the side that's like...
It had like a, it looked like a Star Trek set piece on the side, just a bunch of blinking lights.
Well, yeah, of course it needs that.
Well, it needs to know how to stab at Sonic.
Yeah, no, it needs to gauge how close to the ground it is to then, you know, initiate its thrusters.
See, there it is.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, totally. That's legit.
Okay. No, it checks out. You said it with such confidence that there's no way I could argue.
I feel like there's one here. Could be wrong. Oh. See, and the thing is I think when you interpret some of like the Sonic levels, you interpret getting hit by a spike or a fireball as like a blind.
No, I mean really specifically like where there's an obstacle that you haven't seen at all before because you just haven't scrolled into the stage yet, and then all of a sudden you fall onto spikes.
Right. No.
Or like a lava pit or
whatever. I understand that. And sometimes those obstacles are new. But they're always placed at the same kind of level. So, like, when you start doing a run and you kind of start getting cocky, that's when they'll place one of those enemies. Oh, no, it's just
bad. This one's a tough one.
Oh, I just ran out of rings.
Yeah, you're going to need those rings.
Just a mash of food, is that one?
You're
going to need those rings.
Nuts.
Three is all you need.
That's all you need. One is all you need.
Tails, you fucking son of a bitch.
Tails is always causing so much mischief.
So, and one of the things about this video game combo is there's so many like each level has two variations to it.
Right.
And Sonic 3 did too. Where the first level is a little bit different than the second level. They changed the whole graphical detail, the whole thing.
Yeah. This level does it, and I think, doesn't Marble Garden do a similar deal? Well, no, the Sandopolis
Every level
does.
Every level.
It's like a whole new thing.
Except, I guess, you know, the Flying Battery kind of doesn't.
Yeah, Flying Battery...
Mushroom Hill definitely does.
It changes the color palette. Yeah.
And then it changes back into, like, the...
I think the most drastic one is Sandopolis.
I think this one's the most drastic, because everything...
Yeah, but we're still looking at those stupid rocks. We've looked at those dumb rocks the entire time. Sandopolis goes from, like, your outside of temple to, like, or a pyramid to inside one.
Yeah, no, that's the most drastic, like, design difference. But the whole background in this changes because you go deeper into the cave.
Right.
Which eventually, then inside the cave, you find hidden palace. Mm-hmm. And then that's where you go into, like, the... So this turns into Lava Reef Zone 2, and it instantly changes into like a crystal cave.
Yeah, that's cool.
Which is awesome. Like, see, the whole, now the rocks are like interwoven with crystals.
Mm-hmm.
And it looks totally different.
Yeah, color palette's totally changed. It's a nice detail. It is a, you know, this game is visually less monotonous than some other Sonic games, particularly Sonic 1. Sonic 1, like every...
You think Sonic 1 is visually monotonous?
Yeah, because you have three acts in every world, and there's only five worlds. And actually, you hit the water world twice. So you get six stages on that same background. Which is like, you know, six of 18 stages. It's a big chunk.
Right. Alright. I think for when Sonic 1 came out, I think it's... probably better in that sense than most platform games.
Yeah, without doubt.
I'm desperately trying to find a couple more of these.
A lot of rotating cylinders in Sonic and Knuckles. It's nice.
Yeah, there's a lot of really cool graphical variations. Sort of making you do stuff. Like that... No, see, I'm just kind of stretching myself here, just trying to find some extra...
You're bleeding it dry.
Yeah, I'm trying to find the,
Now you need to find any ring.
I know.
There's some.
Oh.
Ew!
I got a little scared.
I was deaf. I peed a tiny bit. Oh. That was anticlimactic.
See the background?
Yeah.
Totally different.
It is neat.
It's super cool.
Isn't that a switch?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
This just has that hidden secret feeling.
Oh! I felt it!
I really felt it.
Your Sonic senses just tingled like crazy.
Okay, so I'll make a deal with you. If I win this next one, we finish the game. Because we'll just be one away, and I think we can do it. If I don't win this next one,
okay,
which is a high likelihood, we'll end the playthrough here. Or the Let's Play.
Okay.
Are you comfortable with that?
I feel like I don't have a choice.
I'll most likely lose this.
I don't know. I'm kind of an unlucky guy.
Let's see.
Oh!
Woof! Good save. Can you even believe that I just did that?
You know, and I should be rooting for you to die, but it was so intense.
Pretty impressive.
Oh. What kind of black magic is this?
I can't even believe I actually remember that. It's just all coming back to me, dude.
Yay.
Three more. But where are they?
I see them.
You see him, you just don't want to tell me.
I left one more. Oh,
there we go.
That's only two, pal.
Ah! I guess we're in it for the long haul.
Oh, cool. And we'll see you next time on part two of Ray's Mighty Sonic and Knuckles playthrough.
Dude, how can you call it quits when we're so close? I mean, we literally just have one. And then once we're hypersonic, we just fly through the rest of the game.
You know, one time, so a little personal background on me. I worked in the television industry for a number of years. I was a cameraman. And on a home improvement show, one time, I was asked to literally film paint dry. I'm not kidding. Like, a producer asked me to set up a shot on my camera to watch paint dry.
That's pretty intense.
So I know intimately what boredom feels like. And, I'm not gonna say this is that bad, but it's approaching that level.
You need to have a better attitude about things, Brandon.
I just don't like Sonic as much as you do, Ray. You have to accept these things. I feel like you and that flame shield are being a little too arrogant right now. You're just showing off that you're impervious to fire.
Well, I am.
That's true.
Oh, I got cocky. God, that is so gritty.
That's what caused your death. You were just being enchanted.
Yeah. Just kind of excited about it. This is fun though, if you do that. Then you're like, I'm almost falling off. No, I'm not.
You saved him.
So
I feel like if I were teetering on the edge of a cliff right now like Sonic, I may not have the same amount of balance as he does.
That's probably true. So, in my opinion, this part that's coming up on this level is one of the cooler parts about this game and any Sonic game ever made. Mm-hmm. So this is kind of really, the end of this level is really when you sort of figure out what's kind of going on. I stay on this. In terms of the story, right? Mm-hmm. Because in a little bit, we're gonna end up seeing the bottom of the Robotnik Doomsday, you know, which is basically like the Death Star or whatever.
You're not talking about the Death Egg, are you?
Or the Death Egg, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Which is, right.
Which is the Death Star, but in egg form.
Yes. And it's kind of stuck down here, and you're working your way back up into it.
Oh.
Christ almighty.
Nope. No, he won't save us now. I think he's mad. He's actually probably laid back in a sweet recliner playing Mario World, just having the time of his life.
Who?
Jesus, Diamond J.
Oh.
No, he's playing Joshua.
Totally worth it. Alright, do we have another... Do we have another special in this game? No.
Oh, goddammit.
I think we're getting this.
any mercy in this universe. Well, not the kind of secret you want. For all the beans.
Alright, last one. 64 of these.
Are you gonna get back into a corner if you go to one of the ones that you see?
No, I'm trying not to backtrack until. So, the way that some of these stages work is there's a few paths.
Yeah.
And you have, and they both start at the beginning of the stage. So you need to, the easiest way to do it is complete one path completely,
and then get on the other one.
Yeah, and okay. Then come back to the other one. So that's why, like, I'm getting some stuff and leaving other stuff so I can tell where I've been.
I see. Breadcrumbs. Six more. I saw some. Ah! There they are.
Did it.
You did it. You fucking
did it.
I
told you I could do it.
Well,
I
now
told you I could do it.
Now if the laptop doesn't crash, you you have proof of it.
That's right. Sonic got all super emeralds. I love that it actually changes the wording too to say
it's just that extra little
it's that polish.
Little push.
You got them all.
Is this is something happening?
Yep.
Ooh.
This is nice. Watch, power comes outward now.
Sonic can be hypersonic.
Little step above supersonic.
Prove it. Go get 9 more rings and prove it, big man.
You're ready for this?
If you hold on to all those rings. There we go. Do it. Fucking do it.
Wait for it.
I'm waiting.
Boom.
Oh, he has a little trail, too.
And
he does, like, change colors.
Yeah, it does all kinds of stuff, so...
You can walk on lava.
You can also, like, flash yourself up and forward. See that?
Oh!
Right into death? That's a problem. If I do have to complain, like, the supersonic aspect to these games...
Hard to control?
Yeah, it's just, you know, the game's really built for the... normal Sonic.
Uh-huh.
So supersonic kind of breaks it.
He's really, really fast.
Yeah.
And he flies off all the time. Oh, gotcha.
See, like, so that right there was something that could be mistaken for a blind enemy.
Mm-hmm.
But it's actually not, because that yellow thing on top warns me about that. I just chose to kind of ignore it and get by.
You're like the James Dean of Sonic games. I'm like the Jimmy Dean of Sonic games. All I want to do is eat breakfast food right now. No!
That was a good save, though. I could have fallen farther. Okay, so this is the part I was talking about. So I'm climbing up these stairs. See that in the background?
Yep. See how that's the bottom of the
It's his face.
Yeah.
It's Robotnik's face. Oh, fuck you, Knuckles.
And then Knuckles throws me back down.
Why aren't they friends yet?
They should just be friends already. And remember, everything's sort of frozen, right?
Mm-hmm.
And watch, like, he turns on the afterburners and it freaking fries everything. Like, I just love that. Like, now I'm fighting the boss on a totally different look than either of the other two acts. Like, that's just really good narrative.
But
like,
it just changed to fucking orange. That's all it did.
And the background turned red. It got
the wavy...
The wavy heat stuff on there. It's still... They didn't have to do that. They didn't have to do anything.
He said he turned on afterburners.
Yeah, you didn't see him do that?
No! I just saw that the colors change.
No, he turned on the eyes. Out of the eyes came the flash of the afterburners, and then the eyes are glowing red now.
I may have blinked and missed that.
Did you totally miss that animation?
I saw a flash, and then
that
the color
changed.
That
is so crazy. You missed, like, one of the coolest parts of this whole game.
Yeah, no. Forgive me.
Can you go in the lava with your shield?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Anymore?
That ended abruptly.
I forgot that you got it.
The spikes.
That's a good one. This guy's easy. This is a cool level, though. Or a cool boss.
Yeah, I like the rotating foreground thing. It's a neat effect.
And I love that, like, you were going through this cave, right? At the same time that, Oh, yeah. What am I doing?
Yeah, what are you doing?
You gotta go hide!
Dude, he looks super cool.
He does it pretty cool.
I mean, now we're guaranteed to just end up with this. I was hoping to get this at the end of the third level,
mm-hmm.
which would have made the whole play let's play much faster.
Yes.
But you know, I wasn't able to.
What's important is that we're here now. And there's an end in sight.
So check this out. Everything sort of dried up.
Right. We saw this,
you find
in
this
the previous
out later.
Part in Lava Reef.
You find this out later that's because he flew away. So like the jets that you saw get turned on that like blasted everything go away because he's flying in the air right now. So Hidden Palace Zone is a march up into Sky Sanctuary where you jump onto him flying away.
Again, I'm not... Obviously, you know...
I just think that's cool. It's a cool narrative. Like,
I just... It's amazing to me that you, like... That you catch these details.
It's just obvious to anybody playing the game right
now. I'm sorry. It's not...
I mean, anyone... Do you see him flying away right now?
I see him in the background.
Brian, that's obviously attempting to show you him flying away. I understand you being skeptical to try to prove some points later or something, but you can't deny what I'm telling you. Like, it's obvious that that's what's going on.
Of all the episodes where I've wanted feedback...
And this is cool. You finally get to, you know...
Yeah, you're fighting that asshole. Knuckles. Yeah, but anyway, of all the things we've ever done that I wanted feedback, I want feedback
so
on
let
this
me,
one.
Let me continue this, because you obviously have never played this game. So, I just beat Knuckles, and then Knuckles is flying back here because he was killing you trying to protect the Chaos Emerald.
Uh-huh.
And now you see him, because Robotnik's stealing it to power his Death Egg.
Right.
And then you see Knuckles attacking him, right? And getting electrocuted the shit out of. And this is where Knuckles turns sides and becomes Sonic's friend, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's just a cool narrative, like... Like, you're like, what?
Yeah.
You're like, what's going on?
Whoa!
And Knuckles is like, let's go, bud.
And all of you just blindly, like a fucking sucker.
Yeah.
Blindly following.
Like, he's just like, you know, hey, I didn't realize that guy was an asshole, and he totally is. Follow me. I'm gonna help you go get him. You know, that's kind of cool.
cool.
And then you go to Sai Sanctuary Zone. So Hidden Palace Zone is literally just that narrative part.
Yeah, just that world where the Chaos Emeralds are. And now you fight...
and now he's obviously flying away.
And now we agree.
And all the Robotnik...
I can see without a shadow of a doubt that he is flying away.
The robot Robotnik is flying out.
I'm on board 100%.
And I just... Oh, no?
No, he survived.
Good job, Sega, throwing that in there. Because I totally would have died. Thanks, Knuckles.
Fuck you, Knuckles.
Okay, pause this. Okay, welcome back to the Autofire Power Hour. I am going to be, this is Ray, continuing our quest to defeat Sonic 3 and Knuckles. Ryan decided that he could not stand watching the rest of the game being, the rest of the 20 minutes or so of this game. I don't know how much is left time-wise, but he decided that that was going to be too painful for him. I guess Brian doesn't like playing video games or something. I do like playing video games, so I am going to finish this masterpiece of a video game here. So, let's see. So, Sky Sanctuary, if I remember right, isn't all too long. Oh, that's right. We have so many bosses. Hello, Mechasonic. So this is actually our first time seeing Mechasonic in the game. I'm not doing too well. Let's grab a coin here. And so instantly when you look at him, he's kind of a weird mix between the Mechasonic in Sega CD or in Sonic CD and the Mechasonic from Sonic 2. Sonic 2's Mechasonic looks really robotic. You know, kind of metal plates and things everywhere. The character design in Sonic 3 and Knuckles, however, are a lot more refined in terms of just kind of the extra polish. They all look shiny and everything. You can tell by the Robotniks. And, but one of the things, so, anyways, we'll see Mechasonic again here soon. But one of the things that I really sort of like about this game as I try to reach those, these clouds over here, is every level, if I'm not mistaken, there might be a few that don't do this, finding it difficult talking and playing the game at the same time. But, most levels have, like, some added mechanics, so... You can see I was grabbing onto a pole, now I'm sort of popping off these clouds. And most 2D platformers that you'll play... Am I going backwards? Most 2D platformers that you'll play, they might, may or may not introduce any new mechanics later in the game at all. But you'll never really see one do it every, you know, on every level. That's for sure. So, but this game does, and I think that speaks a lot to how much effort and originality and all that good stuff they put into this game. Oh, I thought I could catch that. That was no good. Oh, I gotta beat this guy with no rings. Great. I think this one's not that easy. But yeah, so here's Mechasonic again. And for everyone familiar with the... I knew I was going to die. With the Sonic CD version, he's really kind of like a lot smoother and sort of has a blue shell, making him look a lot more like Sonic on those. So this one, and it's the only time this version... So Sonic 2's version of... I think I got to go up here. Of Mechasonic. Sonic 2's version and this version in Sonic 3 Knuckles are the only times we see those two particular versions at all. And I think I mentioned this on a Knuckles Chaotix Let's Play we did, but Knuckles Chaotix was the second time they actually used the Sonic CD version of Mechasonic. And that episode, or that game sort of solidified the look of him. So moving forward, they used the Sonic CD look. So, okay. I'm a little suicidal when I play Sonic games, and I often pay the price. Okay. So, in an attempt not to be completely boring, I will put a little bit more effort into my, fighting of bosses. Especially because later on, and especially the ending of this game, will definitely try my patience in terms of, having to concentrate and talk at the same time and fight what is a really epic and hard boss fight. So I think he'll sort of be forced into knocking some of these eggs off every time I hit him. And with most Sonic bosses, once you sort of figure out their weakness, they kind of become a lot easier. So there we go. Once I actually sat down and concentrated a little bit, take this warp. And then this spinny thing, there were in the second level of Sonic 3, there was a similar little platforming piece. They were a lot smaller. You sort of just spun in a circle. But this game, they got, or at least later in what is one game, they got a little bit more creative and made these big swingy sort of spinny platform. So you will hear me go silent, especially when I have to concentrate a little bit, because I do want to make it through this game. And right now I've which is what is fairly rare for me. I have, could have saw that coming with the animals trying to escape. But, I'm not very comfortable playing this late in the game with, only four men. I usually have maybe 15 or 20 at this point. So I think this is getting to the, yeah, there we go. So, now that looks a lot like Sonic 2, some of this guy's moves. So this is sort of like playing Sonic 2's boss. Or the second to last boss, I guess. He's got a few extra moves, and he looks way tougher. Pretty metal here. Man, I still can't believe Brian couldn't make it through the rest of this game. I don't know what his grief is with playing good video games. I don't know what that's all about. So, Mechasonic is defeated here. So, we are attempting to make it up to the Sky Sanctuary zone falls apart right beneath our feet due to the what I presume to be the thrusters on this death egg flying into the air. I imagine those are some pretty intense shockwaves. So what's really cool about, especially, and this must have been them, now this is, that's undeniably a cool looking level. But I don't know if it was just the folks making this game having more time to kind of add, you know, a lot of these extra cutscenes. Sonic 3 alone has... Oh, I didn't make it. Has a lot of cutscenes in and of itself. But the ones in Sonic 2 are just really, really good. I keep forgetting that I don't... So let's wait for this. Shoot up. Oops. Stuff on this one. Yeah, and so the way that you get to each level, it's just... It's really cool the way they lay it out. It just adds some extra character to it. Kind of, it gives you a why, like, why am I here, what am I, what's this level all about? Instead of, you know, in Sonic 1, just being forced to play a casino zone without any explanation. So, and although I'm not looking for any Chaos Rings, because I'm already have all the emeralds, I'm trying to remember if there are... If there are any of the larger rings in this level. And this level's really cool. They play around with gravity a lot in this level. So I think at some point I'm walking on the ceilings. So I really think this is kind of above and beyond from a platforming perspective. Just playing with a lot of the Sonic mechanics and, you know, some stuff that you've seen in some way, shape, or form earlier in the game, they really take it up a notch. So, and flying in that sort of energy tube, you saw, like, all kinds of, you know, little hidden goodies I was missing. And it always drove me crazy that I was flying by those, but... I am on a mission to get this game completed. It's no good. So, if you notice on that part, right when I came after the that little spiked area, there were rings right there ready for me to get. You know, assuming that I was going to lose them all just because that part's really hard. And so this game does a really good job with sort of punishing you if you fail, but not completely, leaving you out to dry. And I better get moving here. I think I missed my ride. Oh. I can't believe I didn't get that jump in. We'll get back there. Getting a little nervous about the player count here. I'm wondering. Nerf that. Nope, it does not protect me from that electricity. That was a bit difficult. So now I'm kind of thinking I should bypass this sort of energy tube that it shoots me into. Man, the background, I can't get over. It's really cool looking. So, let's go ahead and nab that. And let's see what's over here. Would have led me over here earlier had I gotten some secret route. Just floating over this. Ah, I see. Okay. I need to get past this part. Okay, so let's bypass that. Is there any way for me to get... Yep. There we go. I need to get 100 rings. Oh, Jesus. That's what I get for not paying attention. See, the thing about the way they design these levels is there's these short-term, and I was describing this earlier, so this probably sounds repetitive, because I'm actually in the real world a few days later from the recording, so I may repeat myself a few times. But these levels are designed, number one, they're designed in 3D and then put into a 2D plane. And then, but the basic level, the focus of the level is broken into short, medium, and long-term goals. So, like, the platforming piece that I'm right now is kind of, essentially a tails reversed course on this. It's essentially a short-term goal within the level. Like this little platforming section. Oftentimes they'll be broken up by basically respawn points, the checkpoints, but not every time. Some sort of medium length sections will have multiple kind of short goals within them. So see, right there, that proves my point, you have a checkpoint. So I'm actually gonna take this because, oh shit, not the one I wanted. This one is a tad bit more difficult to achieve my goal of padding the number of lives I have. And you will hear me refer to how many lives I have by how many men I have, because it's just a habit that's hard to break. Oh, dude, nice. Wow. I even got enough there that I think I should... I mean, testing... Like, I just gotta continue. Ah, well, there you go. At least I got one. And I'm hesitating to go as hypersonic because I feel like that's an easy way to die. But I do have a lot of coins, so... yes. So I believe to get out of this one... So that was actually a terrible time to become hypersonic. But to get out of this one, I think I gotta turn all these things red. See, and this is just, like, kind of one of the cool extra mechanics that... I mean, look, they designed this whole, graphically and everything, they designed this whole section just for this... It's kind of this gravity game. There we go. Ugh. I think... That one's a short one, but I think there's three or four of those we have to do. Another one. I think this one's a lot longer. I wish there was some reward besides the graphical pleasure of flying through this tube here. I wish you got like some coins or something. So I'm passing up a lot. There's a lot down there. Okay, well, this will get this guy. This is a cool looking boss. Tails. Always getting in the way. Yeah, that is not an easy boss. I'm glad I was hypersonic. So I can't remember if this one has three acts or if it's just the two. I guess we'll find out. There's not a whole lot left to this game. Like, look at that. You got Earth in the background. I'm on the outside of the Death Egg. This is cool stuff. And I think almost every level of this game, I think, has multiple, two backgrounds per zone. which is for sure above and beyond. I remember, this is more the gravity stuff. I remember Brian complaining about the background, like, on the bosses of Lava Reef Zone, the background, and it was just for the boss, change colors to red and stuff, and he was complaining that was just a palette swap. Even though in that level, the background had already changed. I think it changes two or three times. So, you know. Oh, I got confused. Alright, hope I get. Yep. Typical Sega. It'll give you a hard sort of ending to kind of one of their medium goals within the level. And then a checkpoint and then some coins just to kind of recover. But it is making my life a little bit difficult this level in terms of getting 100 rings, because there are some challenges here. Like this section. Let's open that coin. And here we go, we get another checkpoint. Oh, right before, really hard section, and no coins. Ah, that's tough. Well, okay. I like that in testing, they must have seen that when starting this section, people probably came back to search for coins, and they threw that spring down here. I like looking for sort of level design. So I guess I'm on my own. If you fail the first part, shit. We might have to start this level over. I can't remember. I haven't continued much. I can't remember if you continue in the middle of the zone or if you have to start the zone completely over. Oh, jeez. If the latter is true, I should probably just restart now. It's kind of cool because playing this upside down seems like it would be super confusing, and it's not necessarily easy, but this game controls really, really well, so. And you're so used to the physics at this point that it's actually not that cumbersome. Which I think is impressive. Oh my gosh, it's gonna spread across.
Jump!
So anyway, and the other thing about when you understand how this game is designed, I remember Brian complaining about a lot of blind spots and blind enemies, but when you understand, that stuff can be surprising unless you understand how the game itself is designed and presenting challenges. So they're always broken up, like that guy was predictable. A replay might show that I actually tried to go backwards, understanding that I may have just made a mistake. But it's very clearly broken up. And so the challenges at that point become much more about timing and anticipation than anything else. And I think, to me, that's one of the more enjoyable things about this game. But again, you gotta kind of like playing video games to appreciate it, I guess. This level's cool. Yeah, I don't think there are any chaos rings in this level. I think if you get this far and you don't have all the emeralds, you're kind of screwed in terms of kind of completing this game 100%. So, and a keen eye will notice that I'm slowing down and like kind of changing my speed at certain points, kind of anticipating. So that was a trick to get you to jump and reverse course. There we go. complete a section and get a checkpoint. Here we go. This is the one I want. Although I really hope I don't want to lose this shield I have. And I lost it. Let's see if I can get it back. There. Fire. I do feel like I'm pretty close to... Oh, I missed that. To 100 rings, 30 away. Oh man, that is a... I can't believe I got through that. Nice. So that helps. I think he actually got me an additional 10 rings. Really wish I had the lightning shield though. Alright. I actually don't remember this. Yes. Yeah, the lightning shield would be. So what I have to do is I actually have to go to here. There we go. And get those to fall on top. Just another cool little gravity boss. Yeah. Oh, I knew it. The thing that you have to be careful for is the explosions. I don't know why the new one didn't get him. I'm not having a lot of luck here. Oh my gosh. I felt like that should have hit the damage box. Yeah. Some of these are exploding at times that. Oh, get the coins, get the coins. Oh, no way. Oh my gosh, I just realized, why didn't I just become hypersonic? Wow, I can't believe I didn't even think of that. That is crazy. Shoot. Timing is off. Nope. Bad timing. Just before my trap sprung into, man, how many hits is this guy gonna take? Although, I wonder if I would have even been able to, that was probably a bad decision there. I wonder if I even would have been able to hit him as hypersonic. I definitely would not be in such a precarious position. Oh, I should have jumped. Man, I don't see any way to go back. 12 rings, that's what I got. Let's see if we can actually get the timing here. Now I run the danger of kind of getting greedy out of frustration. Because this guy tests patience. I missed him. Oh my gosh. Oh, thank God. Tails finally helped me. I really can't die here. Thank you. Oh, my timing is so off. I kinda want this last one to explode. I guess it kinda doesn't really matter, because he's got a pretty good rhythm in terms of when he launches these things, so they're probably coming out at similar times. I think I got him there.
Alright.
And I can't lose my one ring. I think it's when he goes back that way. Yeah, this goes back to an era where the last levels could really be testy. I think one reason the boss is the way that it exploded right before, the boss is the way it is, you know, video game designs, just like movies or other media is about pacing. So they'll throw in something like this to make what's coming next feel bigger than it might actually be. Just kind of after doing something monotonous, basically, the next part, you know, will be a little bit overwhelming, at least at first. Dude, I'm not doing good here. Or at least it not being effective. I think that's solid.
Boom.
Good. Yes. Oh, thank God. Fuck you, Robotnik. Almost got him. And now. Oh. Whoops. There we go. Should have just chased him out. Oh, look, instantly. Oh my God. How could I not remember that? So this is cool. So I'm chasing him. He's out, you know, I can see it's some giant robot. And this for sure has some challenging moments. I know there's some rings coming. Are there? Before this part? Oh boy. Did I miss some? Oh, what was that? Alright. Getting uncomfortably low and continues. Not beating this game at this point would be really kind of embarrassing. I do love how the robot is covered in what I presume to be, like, just guns all over its torso. That's the last finger. There we go. Alright, moment of truth.
Okay.
I got this. I can do this. So, I hope people understand kind of what I was saying about going through the monotonous boss we kind of just went through, and then having to fight this guy, which is kind of challenging all around. Tails! Oh yeah, that felt good. Okay, now I can't remember if there's something else or if now it's the Doomsday level. I remember this. This is kind of just a reward for doing what I did, which I will take because this is extremely enjoyable. Now, if this debris was dangerous in any way, I would have a different feeling about that part. Here we go, Doomsday Zone. So I start off with 50 rings. So my goal right now is just going to be to collect as many rings as I can. I feel like I'm making a little bit of progress here. In terms of getting my number as high as possible. Oh, you know, since Brian couldn't handle playing one of the best games ever made, because he must not like video games or something, I am really glad that he's missing this, because this level's awesome. And it does have its challenges, but it is very rewarding for all the work you have to do to actually get it. So, let's fly up here. Oh yeah, I gotta fly his own missiles into him. Basically means I gotta kind of jet around. This is obviously Robotnik escaping. Although, if Brian was here, he would kind of deny that was hard to decipher, I think. But, you know, I kind of feel it's obvious. Come on. Get some more missiles. There we go. So I still have my rings are still counting down. Oh my gosh. Okay. So that gave me a chance to get some more rings, but I'm not really seeing any, and this is starting to get a little scary. Because the guy that came out of there did not look like... Oh, he's right here. Oh, sweet. I do not remember that at all. So I just gotta hit him. Wow, I wish I would've realized that a few seconds ago. Oh my gosh. I like that it's not that I have to get worried about getting hit, because I'm invincible. I have to worry about defeating him within an allotted period of time. And it does take some time every hit, because I sort of spin out of control and can't collect any rings. Oh my gosh. There we go. This is kind of fun though. There we go. And the rings countdown stopped. I took the Chaos Emerald, the Super Emerald, whatever it's called. I'm flying back down to Mobius. Getting caught by Tails on the descension back into the atmosphere. So, I don't know where Tails got his plane, considering he was on the the Death Egg when I guess I left him behind. But, you know.
So that is Angel Island.
And Brian had mentioned Angel Island was floating. Angel Island has never been floating. And can't float unless it has all the Super Emeralds. So now that they're no longer being used is when the island will sort of float back up into its rightful mystical place. So that last part of the island floating up, and I believe this part, are not in the ending if you beat it without all the Super Emeralds. In addition, I don't believe that you have the dolphins and the seagulls flying behind you and swimming behind you when you beat it without all the Super Emeralds. I think it's just Sonic flying in the air. So, because Brian apparently doesn't have the patience to sit down and do anything for 2 hours, I'm sure he will not watch the end of this episode and will not be, pleasured with the amazing ending we're seeing here. Yamamoto. Yamamoto was, I believe, in all the first original Genesis games as a designer. I think he's one of the original guys, and then I keep saying the guy's name wrong, but I think it's Himnoso or something. Who actually, he did Sonic CD, and then I think also actually came up with the character. And then Yuji Naka has developed the engine and produced and directed all the Sonic games. Yeah, and then I think Brian was saying that the sprites were better in the second one. I've heard other people say that. I think the Sonic 3 and Knuckles character designs and sprites are the best well done. So differences would be the shoes are a little shorter, the hands are a little bit more sort of anime style, it's a little bit shinier, his hair and spikes are a little bit more shiny. The head looks a little less like Felix the Cat than maybe some of the other Sonic sprites. So I think in Sonic Mania, I think they're using the Sonic CD sprite is what it looks like to me, with some of the other sprite animations from some of the other Sonic games, which is the Sonic 1 sprite with some additional kind of animations. But here we go. Oh yeah, there you go. Sonic the Hedgehog 3 and Knuckles with the hypersonic finish. So this is another, I think, cutscene that you don't see if you don't have all the Super Emeralds. I may be wrong. I want to say that there's a splash screen that has Robotnik kind of juggling all the Chaos Emeralds in front of you. In fact, I'm almost sure that's what it is. And that splash screen kind of just... I mean, you know, Sonic 3 and Knuckles could have been like the official name of the game. So there it is. There's the full playthrough of Sonic and Knuckles, the second half of Sonic 3 and Knuckles. I hope you enjoyed it. I know Brian did not because he's not here. But I like playing video games, especially some of the best video games of all time. So I'm here finishing the episode. Thanks for joining.